Yo, what's up? It's Patrick from Guy in the Cube, and in this video, I'm going to show you how you can create and maintain your hybrid tables with Tabular Editor. Stay tuned. If you find this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date from all the videos from both Adam and this guy. All right, hybrid tables. I did a video on them. If you haven't watched that video, you should go check this out. But someone recently asked this, like, all right, I don't want to use Power BI Desktop. I use Tabular Editor to design my models. How do you create and maintain a model with hybrid tables using Tabular Editor 3? The person was Chris Wagner, right? You guys know Chris Wagner, Mr. Data God himself, right? He asked that question. I was like, oh, Chris, it's just, you know, tinkering with this right before the live stream, and I gave him the answer. He was like, boom, it works. So I decided to do a video. You guys know what I like to do. Instead of all this talking, let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. So the first thing you need to do is get Tabular Editor. I'm working with Tabular Editor 3. Pretty sure this will work with Tabular Editor 2. And you must also have premium or premium per user. So once you have that all set up, then you go ahead and choose file, new, and choose new model. We're gonna make another change to this, but for now, just go ahead and change this to Power BI Dataset 1560. Keep this checked, because we're going to use our premium or premium per user workspace to do all of our work. As we're designing this out and making changes to this, it's all going to automatically be saved up to that workspace. All right, then click OK. It's going to say, hey, what's the XMLA endpoint for your workspace? You pop that in there and choose integrate it and click OK. It's going to ask us to authenticate to that workspace, choose your credentials. Then it's going to say, all right, what's the name of this database? So we're going to call this custom hybrid tables, and we're going to click OK. And if you go to the workspace, what you'll see here is that it's going to create that data set for me out here. And you see the little emphasis on the top left corner of it was letting me know it's a newly created data set. The next thing you want to do is create a data source. So we're going to right click here and choose import tables. So we're not going to use this implicit data source credentials managed by the service. I'm going to use Power Query as my data source, and we're going to click next. And then we're going to choose a Azure SQL database. We're going to name this AdventureWorks DW. Click next. And then we need to authenticate to our source, put your server name, then put your account, and then put your database name. Click OK. And now you choose from a list of available tables or views. We're not going to use direct query because we're going to customize this. It's going to be a hybrid table. Tick, 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 tick. Give it some time. So many authentications. There we go. Here's our schemas. But within that schema, and we're just going to use a view for Power BI Internet Sales. Let's get a little real estate here. Make sure we choose the right table. Click it. There's my preview. And then we're going to click next. Make sure you say create partitions using M, and we choose finish. Now we're going to save this. So once we save this, it's actually going to save this to our workspace, and it's going to give me a local BIM file. So we're going to call this custom hybrid tables, and then we'll just choose save. Yep, and now we're done. If we go back to the workspace and we go to set up a schedule refresh, it's going to say one of my sources is not ready. But if we expand this out, there's my data source. It's ready to go. I don't need a gateway, so I don't have to worry about that. Everything's set up. There's my table. But now what we want to do is we want to answer Chris's question. What do we need to do to manage and maintain our hybrid table? So we have the model set up with the data source, and we actually have our table in, but now we want to set this up for hybrid tables. First thing you need to do is click that model, and then make sure you open up the properties window and expand database. Right now, the compatibility is set to 1560. We need to change that to 1565. The next thing you need to do is we're going to create two partitions. One partition that is going to be this year, and then we're going to create another partition that's going to be last year. But we're going to do something a little different. In my initial video on hybrid tables, when you set up your hybrid table using Power BI Desktop, the most recent partition is the one that's going to be in direct query. We're going to flip the script because our end users want blazing fast performance. We only refresh our data warehouse once a night. So we're going to refresh that partition for the most recent data, which is this year. We're going to pull that data into cache. Okay. We're going to import that part of it. And then the older data, data that's last year, they don't access that data that much. So we're going to make that direct query. So you choose last year, and you're going to write an expression for last year. You should be able to get a copy of these in the description below. You can see right here, I say in previous year for that order date. So that's my last year partition. Make sure that partition is selected. Under options, you can see the mode is default. I'm going to choose direct query. And then for this year, I have another query that I wrote, and you can see is in the current year, and make sure that one is set to import. Then we're going to save. It's going to save it up to our workspace database. I'm going to open up Power BI Desktop. I'm going to live connect to that data set because I want to see what's going on. So I'm going to choose Power BI Datasets as my data source. There's custom hybrid tables. click create. You're gonna see, here's my table, and I'm gonna just bring the order date over into a table on the page. And so it's taking a bit because it's actually running a query at the source. And you can see it's from January 2021, if I sort this, to December 2021. So there's no 2022 data in the model because I haven't refreshed the model yet. That partition is import, and the only way for me to get data into that partition is to actually schedule a refresh or do a refresh now. If I bring over some value, order quantity, you'll see it's querying, going out to the source. There's my data. So let's change the basic filtering. Let's go to relative date and say in the last 1 year. So we're going to keep this that way. And then I'm going to copy this and I'm going to paste this over here. On this one, I'm going to say relative date is in this year and click apply. There's no data. So I have data for the last year, but none for this year because I need to actually go out and refresh my data set. Let me go back to the workspace. Insane, amazing. And then go find my data set and do a refresh of it. It's in progress. Shouldn't take too long. It's finished. Head back over to my report. And now remember, this is direct query partition. That's why I didn't need to refresh it because it's just querying that data in real time. Well, it's going back to the source. And then if I choose refresh, you'll see data for 2022. And that's because I actually did a schedule refresh. So you schedule a refresh and it's only going to refresh that partition of data. The direct query partition is not gonna get refreshed because anytime someone interacts with data beyond this year, it's gonna go in direct query mode. All right, Chris, what do you think, right? What do you guys think? Any questions, comments? Are you playing with hybrid tables? I'd love to know. Let's continue the conversation. Where? In the comments below. If it's your first time visiting the Guy in the Cube channel, hit that subscribe button. If you like my video, big thumbs up. As always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.